सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। Welcome you all with my love and respects. I thank the First Christian Church and its pastor for hosting this program, and my blessings to them. Dhyanapitam, Oklahoma chapter. All the people who created and supported the mission in many ways. Some may be here, some may not be here. But I take a moment to send my love and blessings to everyone. As you all may be aware, this whole trip, this whole tour, I'm dedicating it to Patanjali's Yoga Sutras, the father of yoga tradition, one of the oldest spiritual science happened in the planet Earth. I can say Patanjali is the master who made whole thing, the enlightenment, spiritual experience, extraordinary miracles, everything as a science. Not only he lived and radiated, he created a science to achieve that power and radiate those extraordinary experiences. So, I have dedicated this whole trip to this Patanjali's Yoga Sutras. Today I will be speaking on 17th Sutra. Each Sutra is independently intelligent to lead you to enlightenment. Each Sutra is independently powerful. You don't even need to be dependent on the other aphorisms. Other words, that sutra by itself is intelligent enough to give you the spiritual experience from the beginning till the end. It can lead you to the ultimate experience. Let's enter into the today's sutra. वितर्क विचार आनंद अस्मित रूप अनुगमात संप्रज्ञातः। दिस इज द ओरिजिनल सूत्र। लेट मी गिव यू द ट्रांसलेशन। रीजनिंग, कॉन्टेम्प्लेशन, ब्लिसफुल फ्लवरिंग, स्टेट ऑफ प्यूर अवेयरनेस are the characteristics of Sambrajñāta Samādhi. In the earlier sutras, Patanjali was describing how to stop the mind, and he was describing the methods, techniques to connect yourself with the cosmos. Now he is directly describing the quality, character of particular state of enlightenment. Please understand, whatever enlightened masters are living, expressing, if you imbibe those characters, those ideas as part of your being, if you internalize, you will also start radiating the same experience. Very beautifully, one rishi speaks about, one enlightened seer, he speaks about imbibing enlightenment. He says, every human being is divine and already enlightened. All you need to do is picking up the body language of an enlightened one. See, all you need to do is to have the body and mind of an enlightened one. The soul is already enlightened. Patanjali very beautifully says, you don't need to acquire enlightenment. You don't need to achieve enlightenment. It is there. But there are some obstacles. Your body and mind may not radiate the truth in its pure form, may not express the truth in its pure essence, may not live it, may not be qualified, intelligent enough to live. So all you need is clean your body and mind so that it starts radiating, so that it starts expressing. Actually, day in and day out, every day I am speaking somewhere. If you see the essence is same. Not only what I am speaking for last so many years, in last 6 years of my public life, almost 5,000 hours I have spoken. Speaking, practically nothing else. In Buddha's life, 40 years he was speaking. 40 years he was continuously speaking. Even a great enlightened master, Ramana Maharshi, who is from my native place, people always think, it is considered, he is remembered as a silent prophet. But if I see the books which describes his discourses and his teachings, per day almost 7 hours he was speaking. Hours together, if you see all the books which speaks about the teachings, his teachings, whatever his teachings transcribe, you see all the books, volumes and volumes. But the essence is same, message is same. Every time when I come to this country, people ask me, Swamiji, this time what program you are going to do? Whatever you name it, I am going to do the same thing. You name different names, no other way. People need different names, some new excitement, some new thing. So you can name it different way, but the truth is going to be same. The thing which I am going to express is same. What I expressed when I first came to this Oklahoma, first program, and now what I am talking is going to be same. Essentially, the truth is going to be same. Maybe I am using different words, different stories, different jokes, different examples. That's all. But the essence is going to be same. I am constantly reminding you. My job is not to give you more and more knowledge. My job is constantly to remind you that whole thing is inside you. Awakening your body and mind to radiate the truth which is already in you. People ask me, then why do you go on talking? Understand, if I just sit, you also can just sit in my presence. It will be really beautiful. I'll prefer that. But if I don't talk, you can't just sit. You will start talking inside you. So naturally, I have to speak some words. So talking is more like trying to entertain you so that you will catch the body language of the master, the life, the energy, presence of the living master. Here, Patanjali is trying to teach one of the ultimate truth to us. Best thing which can happen to a man is the concept, right concept about your body and mind. Just yesterday I was talking about this subject. What you believe as you, that is all needs to be corrected. Nothing else needs to be corrected. Your lifestyle doesn't need any change. Your habits doesn't need any change. Nothing else needs to be corrected. What you believe as you, only that needs to be altered. See, the essence of the whole spirituality or the work of all the spiritual leaders, masters, teachers, the essence is giving you the right idea about your being. What you think as you, as your body, or as your mind, or as you, giving you the right idea about what you are, that's all is the essence. Here, Patanjali is trying to give right idea about what you are, what you think as you. If the right idea is created, that's all. Suddenly you see, constantly you are radiating energy. I have seen, because of my experience traveling all over the world, people who continuously believe in ghosts, only they experience ghosts. Not really. People who don't believe, they don't experience. Ghosts don't touch the people who don't believe them. Now, they are very nice people. They don't go to people who don't believe them. Whatever may be you think as your life, you start expressing it. Whether it is a disease, physical disease, or mental disease, idea about you, whatever idea you carry about you, you constantly make it reality, because your being is such, it constantly supports what you believe and experiences what you believe and authenticates what you believe. This is, in a way, you create self-confidence. Creating self-confidence is almost like a survival need. Just how you need food to survive, you need confidence on yourself to survive. You need constantly, you need to support yourself. I am right, I am right, I am right. Only then you can survive. That is how you can see all your actions. All your actions, you go on justifying that I am right, I am right, I am right. Whatever you do, you go on justifying. That is the basic way your unconscious functions. That is the basic way your inner space functions. That is the basic way, because it is survival. That is a survival need. That's a basic instinct of a human being. So it cannot be any other way. It has to be this way. If you don't support you, who else is going to support you? So naturally, you take energy, you put all your energies and go on supporting what you believe as true, what you think as true, what you trust as true. I always tell people, for healing or transformation of your being, the basic thing is you changing the idea of what you are or what you think as you. That is the basic need. Because whatever you think as you are going to present all your energies, project all your energies and make it reality. I have seen sometime people start believing particular psychic or particular astrologer, in India astrologers, in the West psychics. They start believing particular psychic or particular astrologer. The big problem is, once they start believing, after that, if one or two incidents clicks as per their prediction, after that, whatever they predict, these guys make it as reality. These guys go on making it as reality. I always tell people, if you put that same trust with enlightened master, he will be constantly altering your ideas about you till you achieve that perfect idea. perfect being, perfect settledness. But if it is a normal astrologer or a psychic, what level he is in, he will be going on predicting only in the same level. I have seen sometimes these astrologers, they put the idea, this year is going to be very difficult for you. They put that idea in some of these guys. These guys constantly brag that, and see that year becomes difficult. And see, even small incidents they pick up and connect with it, and see that year becomes very difficult for them. There's a beautiful saying in Sanskrit: all the negativity has only one power over you, that is your faith on it. Your faith on it, that's all. If you have faith, you can see anything into anything. If you start believing, anything can be seen into anything. A simple, you can see in your life. I have seen, if you are continuously watching the horror movies for 10 days, the 11th day, even if a simple screen moving in your bedroom in the night, or one cat jumping, or a little water sound in the bathroom, enough. You start imagining all kinds of things. It is because what you continuously believe, you project and see. You make it outside and see. Because you have so much of energy, understand, whether you believe it or not, accept it or not, understand it or not, you have so much of energy. Your life, just feel the air is going inside and getting purified, becoming part of your body, and the remaining air is going out. Such a big process is happening inside. The bread is getting converted into blood. Means what? You are an energy center. You are an energy center. So much is happening. If there is no proper positive work, naturally you will start doing your own work. If there is no proper positive work, that's what Patanjali says very beautifully. Use your mind, otherwise somebody else will start using it. Before somebody else starts using it, better you start using it. Better you start living it. I have a story for you. How you project things and see. I'll read it out so that you won't miss a line. A visitor to an art gallery was perplexed by what appeared to be nothing more than a blank canvas. As chance would have it, the artist responsible was standing next to him. The artist also was standing next to him. This visitor asked, "I don't wish to appear offensive, but what exactly is it supposed to be? What is this drawing? What is this painting?" Artist replied proudly, "Sir, that is a cow grazing." This guy asked, "Where is the grass?" "Sir, the cow has eaten it." This guy asked, "All right, but where is the cow? You don't think she would be standing there even after eating all the grass?" Understand, empty paper or empty canvas, you can project what you want. You can see what you want. You can experience what you want. The whole life is empty canvas, the blank canvas. You go on projecting what you believe and making it as reality. Start believing it as reality. Here, Patanjali gives the right mental setup with which you can start projecting things, with which you can start seeing things, with which you can start living